Hey guys, it's your boy Coopers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off. I picked up wins in the league over West Brom and Stoke. In this episode, as you can see, I'm going into the Champions League for the first time in season 5, and as you can see, my group contains PSV, Zenit St. Petersburg, and Liga Warsaw. Probably butchered all those. You know, I said PSV, their initials. I still probably butchered something. Chances are I got something wrong. You know. So, what do we talk about today, ladies and gentlemen? I know a lot of you were probably expecting me to crow about the friendly yesterday at Wembley between Liverpool and Arsenal.
What can be a fantastic
I'm not
journey
gonna
if you put it together if you do
because
it big game.
It's
this is the Liverpool side.
It's almost like it's a fake
it's
victory
for them today.
I'll explain what I mean by that. I mean, beating Barcelona is a good result no matter when you do it. But you know, it just doesn't feel like it.
PSV, this is how they'll play today.
I mean,
well, they're going to go with 4-3-3.
I'm going to say it now. We were clearly not playing Barcelona
at
their best.
Describe it as the Dutch
they have a few chances. So, I mean, it wasn't totally
really potent,
but Barcelona,
it can be awkward.
That didn't seem like their players were at the races. Just
Andre
they
Ayu.
Seemed all over the place and just couldn't hang
it back to the goalkeeper.
The players, it was just weird. It was like
they've gone up to take the throw well up the field.
The
pressure on
Liverpool were playing like Barcelona should have been playing, and Liverpool and Barcelona were playing like I expected Liverpool.
They can
play.
Regroup now and a goal kick.
He to get utterly decimated. I mean, even without Neymar, Barcelona will still have a far superior team.
Well, we're at the outset, the group stage. It really is an exciting prospect.
They didn't show it. You know, nothing about that game felt real. I mean,
the sides that
I watched it every. When watched it 9,000, near 9,000 people watched it live,
it's higher than
even they could tell you, they could all tell you that it actually happened, but
no
it just
room for error at
it
all.
Feels like a paper.
Well, it will be a throw. It's gone out of
it almost feels
there.
Like a FIFA.
Andres Guardado.
That's how much it feels like it doesn't matter. I mean, it does in a sense matter. I mean,
now
it's
Wilson.
A big victory. It's a great victory. Yeah, I mean, I'm happy that Liverpool actually picked up.
Well, it's the dream scenario, scoring on your debut.
It's 3 points.
So much of the pressure off.
Point on the line. Well, what that means for the cup or what? I don't know how that.
He could have done better there, but I
don't
know. Such pace on this.
I know Barcelona had to beat Liverpool by 4 goals to win the tournament. I don't know if Liverpool can win it. I think we're playing men's today in that same tournament.
The ball gets to here.
Like, brilliant play.
The defender, it will be a corner.
The day after or a game, brilliant. Yep, that's sure to get somebody injured. Hurt, no doubt it'll be a defender because,
well, the defending
of course, it will.
Easily, you expected more.
As if our defense isn't paper thin already. That's another thing about the result that didn't feel
Luciano Narsic
didn't feel right because
Liverpool take over possession again.
Barcelona didn't even score. We kept a clean sheet. He's playing half the game with James Milner at left back. And no disrespect to James Milner, he was very good last season, especially in the second half of last season. With all of his assists.
Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on. It
left
was a
back?
Bad ball, as it turned out.
That shouldn't have worked. That shouldn't have resulted in a clean sheet. But it did.
But he did it very competently. He's having a good game.
Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you this isn't a good victory. It is a good victory.
Possession's gone away.
Anytime you beat a big team, especially one of the best teams in the world, like Barcelona, anytime regardless of where they were playing at their best or not.
That's in the back of the
it is still their victory. But unless Liverpool can constantly can show this level of performance in the league,
from distance.
I am not going to hold my breath.
The margin here to 2-0.
Shine. Their ability.
They could lay it off to the supporting
play. Show the best that they can be, you know, fight for top four spot, because I just feel like with the
PSV with the throw,
how paper thin our defense is. I mean, a few injuries and we're gonna have no defenders whatsoever, and that's just scary. The fact that we've not signed, like, we've made one outfield defensive signing in Joel Matip. I don't count that 30-year-old guy out.
That's not like him. He's a good one-touch finisher.
Oh yes,
he couldn't finish that one.
For they, so good for him. But still,
that easily. But
there's a difference between playing not the racist Barcelona, playing against the
intercepting, if you like,
Man City with their
half-time
Kevin
now,
De Bruyne,
2-0 is the score
Aguero,
at the break.
Yaya Toure, Nalito,
with 45 minutes gone, and on the
David
first 45
Silva.
Minutes for his new club, how do you think he's done?
I would be happy with that first.
As much as I hate to say it, Raheem Sterling would definitely rip that defense to absolute shreds.
Well,
and they're not the only team.
Captain
Arsenal could probably easily rip through that defense with guys like Alexis Sanchez. I mean, there's some fear that they might not even have a striker for that game. That defense almost doesn't warrant a striker. Just put any old clown up there and it just looks like it's there for the absolute destroying. It looks so weak. I mean,
and the cross
I wish
it
didn't look like that.
Deserved, perhaps,
unfortunately, it does.
What a fine save! It's a corner.
And like I said, the result against Barcelona, I'm gonna be happy about the result, but I'm not gonna
away here.
Say, oh, we're gonna win the league or we're gonna finish top four guaranteed. If we can beat Barcelona, we can beat anyone. That's not the case. We need to show that we can beat Arsenal. If we come out and we show that same level of performance today as we did against Barcelona yesterday. I mean, not today. Apparently, it doesn't start today. It starts for Liverpool. It starts next weekend, next Sunday, when we play Arsenal.
Defender to it first.
At the Emirates.
Andres Guardado.
It's going to be a hell of a game.
We'll take over possession.
If Liverpool
again
can show the same level of
it. That's what they're looking for.
Of if they can be consistent, if they can show that
the
same
continues its coverage
dominance
on the Barclays Premier League.
Well, and not
for Liverpool. They'll be hosting Everton.
Offensive dominance, really, in terms of scoring. If they can produce that,
they have a corner to come via that deflection.
Then maybe Liverpool can be considered as legit challengers for top four. But until I see how they get on against Arsenal, I'm not gonna say that this is.
That was a chance to really get in at the goalkeeper, running off the defender, but he's run offside.
I know there's a few fans out there that wants to believe, and all power to them, but the defense, for me, the defense is a worrying issue. A few injuries, and who are we going to play at defense?
The heaviness of the rain half an hour or so ago. They're always concerned whether the ball can be moved freely and whether it's safe to play.
It's
in that
worrying.
Respect.
Yeah, but I think all the fans, some of whom were getting a bit
worrying. That's worrying.
To see it, the sliding tackle coming in on a.
When it's clear
service
that our backup left back is James Milner, that's a problem. that is an absolute 100% problem. The fact that we are hoping Moreno doesn't get injured. Moreno, who is useless, is better than having James Milner.
These two have got a great understanding with
and
their
that's
passing.
The case for your team. If you have a position that's that weak, you're not going to be improving on that. Is an issue. If you're trying to accomplish something, that is not the way that it will get accomplished. It'll be accomplished.
Not much time to go. What impact will that have on
fix the problem?
Well, Liverpool go up against Everton after this, and why they've played out here today, they'll be full of confidence, I think.
Fix the problem, or it'll just keep coming up.
And here comes the counter attack.
Like I say,
oh, well saved. And the decision is a corner.
Liverpool, if they suffer a few injuries during the season,
well, he was lurking dangerously.
They could be in some serious trouble. Serious, serious trouble.
Routine that worked pretty well until the shot.
And considering
eight shots,
pretty much all our injuries last season were defensively, except for those to Daniel Sturridge, who I'll get onto in a minute.
For the most part, pretty well.
Maxime Lestier.
And the injury to Origi. I almost forgot that. How could I forget the horrible challenge by Fouad Mari, the prick. But defensively, if we got a lot of injuries last season in defense.
Clever, we could be in.
And we have to rely on Kolo Torre. We don't have Kolo Torre. If we did, he'd be
another goal.
He'd probably starting.
Debut, Alan Smith.
Well, if he carries on,
but no, we left him go, and now our defense is paper thin, and I am legit.
He should have done a lot better.
It is a real problem, and I know I'm repeating myself because I am trying to emphasize that I think it's a real problem, and I will emphasize that as well when it comes to my Liverpool FIFA 17 career mode. When FIFA 17 comes out, I will be focusing on defensive players. I will stack defensive players. That is how much I do not want. That is how much I am worried. I don't think I can succeed with that team. That's how bad they are. That is how bad it looks defensively. I don't want it to be the case, but it is. Anyway, talked enough in about the defense and their and the problems that Liverpool clearly have in defense. Let's get on to the problems in the forward department, mainly that of one Daniel Sturridge. He picked up another injury. I was legitimately fooled. I think we were all fooled into thinking that he had finally gotten over all of his injuries and all of his problems and all of the trouble that he's been in over the past few seasons in terms of injuries. I think we all were legitimately fooled into thinking he had actually gotten healthy. He has not gotten healthy, and I am just really thankful that it looks like Origi. I mean, if Origi is not our starting player over Daniel Sturridge, fair or not, then I don't know
Royce in the wide positions.
What
Cristiano
the problem is, because
Neymar.
It's gotten to the point where I would legitimately think maybe we should sell Daniel Sturridge if we can.
Gibson.
I mean, if we can get some kind of money for him and get a less injury-prone striker,
Kevin Morales,
in, then that might be the best option, because having a guy who pretty much can't seem to move without picking up another injury. That's problematic.
With the Everton player. Gonna cross it. And he's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
And
this could be it.
With that being said.
Goalkeeper hangs on.
Everton showing their
Nathaniel Clyne.
I'm gonna focus now on Everton and the Merseyside Derby. And Everton are not in a good position in the league. And that goal from Neymar is not gonna help. And why do I say they're not in a good position? They're kinda bomb. As in rock. Fucking bomb. They're 20th. They've only scored 2 goals all in the first 5 games, and they only have 1.
Full marks for the way he lost his marker there.
Yep. Everton are bomb after 5 games with 1 point. So, yeah, I'm top, unbeaten. They are bomb. No wins. 1 freaking draw is that's the only point they have. They have 4 defeats, and they are already 1-0 down. Like I said, they are freaking hoping that I do not score. Already, they have to match their season total so far.
Here's the cross.
And double it.
We've got his fist to it.
To even have a chance. In terms of goals. To have a chance of winning this match.
Powered by Laporte.
And that's as is. If I score again, they'll have to score 3 goals. They will have to score more than they've scored in 5 games in 1 to even have a slight hope. So, yeah. It's not looking good for Everton. And
excellent passing. Great interplay.
I want to say really Roberto Di Matteo because it, I mean, not Roberto Di Matteo, that's someone else. Roberto Martinez.
Throw. Sharply done to restart it here. Gareth Bale. There's going to be a throw in after that tackle.
Challenge on Bale leads to the throw. Ronaldo. Coutinho loses the ball to Baines. They're brain brilliant. Rodriguez.
Concern, I think, from us for today.
There's only lots of space. They're probably talking about Everton's poor form. 1.5 games. Not exactly. Yeah, stay in the Premier League form, is it?
Kevin Morales passing in front of the opposition. But they're still keeping the ball. That's important.
Great challenge there by Marc Laporte.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Neymar.
Cross coming in now.
Oh, Ronaldo couldn't get it in. It just went a little too far for him. It was a few inches back.
It's looking quite good for Liverpool.
Would have just not get it in.
They would have hoped to be in a stronger position, but it could be worse, of course, as we
left everything in a
half-time approaching.
Very bad.
Douglas.
In a way.
Time to be added on is just 1 minute. Everton look like the team in charge, but that's not being reflected on the scoreline.
No, it hasn't. I think the
Ronaldo isn't going to get there.
The fact that the full
on the reference.
There's the halftime whistle. The other results are Chelsea are winning. That's not what I wanted to see, because Chelsea.
Well,
after winning a game in hand, went up into second. They are currently 4 points behind me, so the Spurs can do me a bit of a favor and get a draw or beat Chelsea. That'd be fantastic. Nathaniel Clyne. Throw to Ronaldo. To the man's.
And here's the shot.
Goes for it. Oh, beautiful. That is how you score your first goal for the season in some style. Oh. Oh. And Tillemans has pretty much wrapped up this Merseyside derby.
To place it, and hasn't he placed it beautifully into the left corner?
That is an absolute spectacular goal.
Analyzing again.
It's probably the best goal so far this season. Again, not been that many spectacular goals.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
So far in season 5. I would hope that I can score something.
On to Ronaldo.
A bit more fancy there than that. At least Neymar makes it 3. He no offense, he is needed with the head. All is needed is that it went into the back net. That's exactly where it went.
And here is another angle on that goal.
Are definitely beaten now. They would have to score 3 goals in one game. Having only scored 2 in 5,
I have to say it's
to
so
even come
today,
close
to
getting
to
a point.
They're racking up the goals.
So they'd have to score 4, double what they score in 5 games in 1. Then, yeah. This Merseyside derby is emphatically over before the final whistle has gone. Brilliant. Surprised Baines could keep that in there.
Just to tell you that the
look at my next game, the Capital One Cup game against the Hammers, West Ham. I think I have a game against, what's it, Aston Villa? Yeah, Aston Villa. So, all claret and blue in the next episode.
Over the touchline, that'll be a throw
against
to the
two teams that, well, that I know that were it, Villa and West Ham. I always hated that Villa and West Ham wore the same in color jersey. I mean,
Lukaku.
It makes sense that there's different shades of red in the league. Like Liverpool's red is slightly different to Manchester United's red, and slightly different to Arsenal's red. Chelsea's blue is slightly different to Man City's blue. Ooh, theirs is more of a sky blue. Anyway, you watch Lyre and see in Everton, Chelsea and Everton, sorry. But two teams randomly both wear claret and blue. If I was watching a game and I didn't know who was playing, if I saw the claret and blue, I always thought it was West Ham, and half the time I was wrong, and it was Aston Villa.
Coutinho.
I was like, wait, they both were it? So, you imagine my confusion anytime I saw a game between the two teams. Luckily, there won't be such a problem this season, because Aston Villa will be playing in the championship. Speaking of which, bad start for Newcastle. I won't talk too much about it because I'm not the person to talk about it.
If you're losing count, it's 5-0. Nothing so far in this game to surprise us.
Bad start for
it's only the
Newcastle
that they lead by.
Yeah, it's not always easy coming into a game and everyone's expecting you to get a hat full, but they've kept their focus this side
and
taken the chances.
And considering
when they've cropped up.
So one of my favorite teams to actually Everton's play against in a career month, if I'm being honest.
Next match, Martin, in the Capital One Cup, and
as well as Liverpool, whose former manager Rafa Benitez is at the helm.
Here's a chance
James's
to
Park.
It in. Here's McCarthy.
I am hoping that Newcastle can somehow manage to get back straight away. But losing the first game is not exactly the way to go about that.
Still time for the opposition to spoil Liverpool's day, but they haven't looked like doing it because Liverpool haven't let them look like doing it. Ross Barkley. Ricardo Rodriguez. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Morales. Ross Barkley.
Oh,
used his head there to...
Only 1 minute at a time in the second half as well. To go along with the 1 minute at a time that was in the first half.
Marvellous tackle.
And there's the full-time whistle. Oh, well, little 5-0 Neymar getting that hat-trick. Oh, he got 4 goals! Oh yeah, he scored the first one. I completely blanked that. I completely forgotten who won the, who scored the first goal. Who won the first goal? That doesn't make any sense. Chelsea, Spurs couldn't do me a favor, dumb pricks. See some of my young players that I signed up in the last episode. Paul is being trained. Prestius, let's go with him. Okay, his rating up as high as I can. Brilliant, both Pullet and Wilson go up to 74 and 76 respectively. Fantastic. But a fantastic way to disappoint, not to start. Man, I don't think you know what your role is here. That's concerning. Are you freaking serious? I just looked at the clock. 27 minutes? What the hell? Fucking piece of shit. No. No. Shayojo, what are you asking me? You are asking me to play. Actually, your wish will be granted because you are playing in this match. I'm trying to find a place where I can play for Miss Chow. I'm never gonna get how to pronounce this guy's name. Someone let me know in the comment section below how you pronounce this guy's name. But I just... Wilson plays fantastic. Pollard plays fantastic. And Danilo plays fantastic. I mean, ideally, maybe alone? Because if I really need a central midfielder, I guess I can call upon Tillmans on my bench. Like, I don't know. Should I, what I'll do is, and you can see I, actually got some new scouts. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna list him for loan, and we'll see if I get an offer from a team that I know will play him, then yeah. I mean, 70 rated, he could slot into any championship team, no bother. And with 5-star skills, he's that extra bit deadly. It's just, I can't fit him into this second team. Like, the only improvement is getting Mills in for Brito come the January transfer window. Other than that, I can't really say more than that. And, that's gonna be it. So, thanks for watching as always. Don't forget to smash the like button if you enjoyed this episode. And hit the subscribe button if you're new to the channel. Also, you don't miss any future episodes of this career mode or any other videos I might do. And yeah, until next time, thanks for watching, enjoy, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.